the God of my salvation, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Israel, I come to you in spirit and in truth. Give us this day wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, that we may receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace. My name is Casey Barthel with Israel Productions. Today, with the help of the Holy Spirit, I will testify to the power of the Holy Spirit. But first, I will give God Almighty the praise for being the creator of Israel, as it is written in Isaiah 43:15. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the creator of Israel, your King. And what a mighty and awesome King he is. The power of the Holy Spirit. O great and awesome God of Israel, we thank you for King David, as it is written in Psalms 51:10. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me by your generous spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall be converted to you. King David, a true servant of the God of Israel, truly thankful for the gift of the Holy Spirit that only his God, the God of Israel, can give you. Today, I am not afraid to testify to the power of the Holy Spirit. The same magnificent spirit that King David prayed for, the same powerful spirit that the prophet Moses witnessed with his own eyes and ears at the burning bush. And we all must know that this same Holy Spirit was also promised to all the lost children of Israel that believes in the Son of God, Yahshua, Jesus, the King of Israel. As it is written in 1 John 14:15. If you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper that may abide with you forever, the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. We can clearly see from the Holy Scriptures that we should not expect to receive another prophet, another man, or anyone other than the power of the Holy Spirit. Give the God of Israel the praise for sending to the lost sheep his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. I believe and have received the Holy Spirit. Today, my people, I ask you the same question that the Apostle Paul asked in Acts 19:2. And he said to them, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believe? God Almighty, I thank you for putting in me your Spirit of Truth, guiding and teaching me about your everlasting kingdom, Israel. My people, we know that God is a spirit, and those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. His marvelous spirit has been in the world since the beginning, as it is written in Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created heavens and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters, God Almighty, and His Holy Spirit are one. He is the most compassionate, the most giving. He thought enough of man to share with him His everlasting Spirit by breathing into his nostrils the Spirit of life, as it is written in Genesis 2:7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. What a powerful God we serve. Give God Almighty the praise for putting His Spirit in all mankind, making all mankind a temple to house the Spirit of the living God, as it is written in 1 Corinthians 3:16. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? Give the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob the praise for what He has created in man, the power of His Holy Spirit. But let us not forget that man did not stay true to God, but became an enemy to God by defiling himself with the wickedness of the world, as it is written in Genesis 6:3. And the Lord said, My Spirit shall not strive with man forever, for he is indeed flesh. Verse 5. Then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thought of his heart was only evil continually. My people, we must not forget that we were created to be a holy nation, set apart from all wickedness, as it is written in Exodus 19:4. You have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle wings and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, then you shall be a special treasure to me above all people, for all the earth is mine, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words which you shall speak to the children of Israel. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Be holy, because I am holy, says the Lord. Exodus 3:5. Then he said, Do not draw near this place. Take your sandals off your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. My people, receive the truth. To be holy is to be set apart from all things that did not come from the mouth of God. We cannot add nothing to what God Almighty has set apart for Himself. Judaism, Christianity, Islam, His Holy Spirit will let you know who you are. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. And by believing in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we also can become one holy nation, Israel. Acts 2:1. Then the day of Pentecost had fully come. They were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. the power of the Holy Spirit is real. And I am not ashamed to give my personal testimony to the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah! Thanks to the Holy Spirit, I have power over crack cocaine. Hallelujah! I have power over lust and adultery. Hallelujah! I have received power to be happy and comforted in sad situations. And most of all, I have received power to love when I am being hated and misunderstood daily. Hallelujah! Give the God of Israel the praise for pouring out his spirit on all true believers. My brothers, my sisters, you must pray to the God of Israel for the power of the Holy Spirit. Do not be deceived. You cannot defeat these wicked spirits alone. As it is written in Ephesians 6:12, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. All praise and honor goes to the Holy One of Israel, the Most Merciful, our true Judge. Colossians 3:12. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. But above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. In closing, I thank the God of Israel for being true to his promise and for allowing me to receive his Holy Spirit. Ephesians 5:8. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness, righteousness, and truth, finding out what is acceptable to the Lord. Peace be with you, and may the power of the Holy Spirit enter your life today. Peace.
Soft and warm, a quiet storm, quiet as when flowers talk at break of dawn, a power source of tender force, generating, radiating, turn me on, turn me on. Circuit all my nerves, promising electric things. touch me and suddenly there's rainbow rings. Quiet storm blowing through my life. Oh, quiet storm blowing through my life. Oh, blow, baby.
All honor and glory goes to the God of Israel for the power of his Holy Spirit. Isaiah 63:11. Then he remembers the days of old, Moses and his people saying, "Where is he who brought them up out of the sea with the shepherd of his flock? Where is he who put his Holy Spirit within them, who led them by the right hand of Moses with his glorious arm, dividing the waters before them to make for himself an everlasting name, who led them through the deep as a horse in the wilderness, that they might not stumble? As a beast goes down into the valley, and the Spirit of the Lord causes him to rest, so you led your people to make yourself a glorious name."